In this video, I'll show you how to turn any image into a coloring page and color it fast with AI tools. These coloring books on Amazon are selling tens of thousands of copies in a single month. And you'll notice that many of these high-quality coloring books have a half-color image on their cover. Most AI-created coloring books are using Midjourney full-page image as a cover, and you're likely not even finding them in the content. So a partially colored cover helps people to quickly identify it as a coloring book, and also it signals high quality. Plus, this design provides a preview of the final product, and it's a great addition to your promotional or social media content. I haven't seen this shared in anywhere else before, so if you're interested, let's jump right in. Today, we'll be using Stylar AI, which is the most beginner-friendly and controllable AI image generation tool, in my opinion. They recently have tons of useful updates and new pre-trained models that will make your image creation process more efficient and straightforward. Let's go to their website. So at Stylar AI, we log in and then we will end up in this dashboard. I will include all the links in the description below. On the dashboard, let's select a photo we want to turn into a coloring page. I selected this one I created on Midjourney, and then it would open a new project for you to work on. You will see on the left-hand side the AI tools panel. Down here near the image, you get various functions you can do to the image. And on the right-hand side, you get the generated results panel and also the layer panel for you to work on. Up here next to upgrade, you get to see how many credits you have left. On the free plan, you get 30 credits per day and it resets every day. Click upgrade here and see the pricing plan details they offer at the moment. On the top, we can change our aspect ratio and project names. Let's rename the project, and in here you can also change the aspect ratio. I will keep mine at 1:1 and then click apply. On the left hand side panel, this is where we can get the various AI tools Stylar AI has to offer. So first you can upload your image here if you want to change your image. And we got text to image, in which you can create an image from a text description. Image to image to transform an image into various styles. Local edit to edit a specific part of an image. Insert objects to add an object to your image with image reference. Face swap to replace a face in an image with another face. Face repair to fix and enhance generated faces. Generative expand to expand an image's boundaries. And you can also enhance image to higher quality to improve the image quality and resolution. Today, we'll be using the image to image tool to transform this image into a coloring page style. So we got the image on the board. Let's click image to image. In style, you can upload your own style with the plus sign or pick a variety of their preset styles. One of the styles I like to mention is the color fill style that I think is super cute for children's illustration or animation. And it will really give you an interesting style to work on. But for a coloring book, we can use Simple Playful for a simplified and minimalistic style, or coloring page that is more for intricate and more detailed background. After my testing, I find that coloring page is the style that is more suitable for my project. Next, we can input our own text prompt or click auto prompt so the AI can generate one for you if you don't want to write it yourself. If you use auto prompt, you may want to remove the color descriptors so that the image doesn't turn out with too many colors. For me, I prefer simple text prompts like this: a coloring page of a little girl holding a small animal surrounded by butterflies. And this way, the AI can reference the image more and less on my text prompt. If you don't write anything here, the AI will write one for you. And I find that it will sometimes add unnecessary details that influence the generated results. So use it at your own discretion. Next, under style intensity, we can adjust how strong the chosen style is presented in the result. I normally put it around 0.8. And then in structure match, we can adjust how much the generated image will be influenced by the structure and composition of our image. Because I like the result to be more similar to my image, I put it normally around 0.82. For color match, you can choose to preserve the same color tones in the generated image, but this is a black and white coloring page, so we're going to leave it off. And face match helps to preserve the face identity of a single character, but in here, we can leave it off. In the advanced setting, you can input negative prompts. Here, I put in grayscale and colors, Although I don't think it helps as much as it should. But this is another place you can configure your prompt. And then we hit stylize. So on the right hand side, we get four results generated. And you can click and hover over them to preview the images. I think the results are pretty accurately follow my reference image, just with some extra details in the background. We can click this compare icon to compare it with the original image, and we can download it here. You can also choose to vary one of the images, like in Midjourney, to generate similar results. And it will create four similar ones of the one you choose. For me, I think this one will work. Let's download. Next, we want to clean up the image with Photoshop. If you don't have Photoshop, you can use Photopea, which is a free online platform that works almost the same as Photoshop with a little bit less features sometimes, but it will work on 95% of the things that I'm going to show you. So first we find a downloaded image file. We right click on it and open with Photoshop. The image will be placed in the canvas of the project that we open up. Next, let's go down to the layer panel and add a new fill layer with this icon. Then we click solid color and select white as the color so we get a white background layer. And then we drag it to the bottom to be used as the background. If you couldn't find any window or panel on Photoshop, simply go to window on the top and you can open the panel from here. Next, I click back to the coloring page layer and pick the selection tool and circle the parts that I want to remove, and then we can click delete to remove them. You can also clean up the unwanted details with erasers or the brush tool. By doing these, after getting the result we want, click file, export, and then quick export as PNG. After we got the clean image, we want to vectorize it so we have a crisp, clean black outline for our illustration. To vectorize, I find Kiddo's AI image vectorizer works best in this use case. In a Kiddo vectorizer, we first sign in and then we click vectorize your image. And here we upload the coloring page we just cleaned up. And for color mode, we pick black and white. Then we hit vectorize the image with one AI credit. You will have 20 free AI credits to start, and after that, you will have to upgrade your plan. Here's a glance of their plans, but this is for a later day. So we got our image turned into a vectorized black line illustration with transparent background. And we can then download the SVG, then reopen it in Photoshop or Photopea. To do that, we find the image, right click, open with, and find the Photoshop app to open. And then it will ask us to rasterize the image. In here, we go to the layer panel, click the new fill icon again. Then we also add a solid color and choose white in here. Then we drag it to the bottom as the background layer. You can use the same method to remove the unwanted details further in here. And here we got our finalized clean coloring page image. Click file, export, and quick export as PNG. Next, we want to color our coloring page. We come back to Stylar AI in the same project. Still add image to image. For the style, let's pick Simplify Scenic this time. This is the style I find works best for a hand-drawn feel color page. But there are other options that you can also try. For example, the minimalistic cutesy and pastel deli, I think, could work in this case. So you can try other ones yourself and find your own preference. And this time, we will toggle on the color match, so we will have similar colors in the color version. We can remove the negative prompt here so it will show colors. And with other settings remain the same, we can hit stylize. Then we got some colorful results that match the colors of the original image and with no black outlines. And to me, they look pretty much like you can draw them with color markers. I think this one looks pretty good. Let's download. Next, go back to our previous project with the clean image. Then we drag the color image into the same Photoshop project we had before that has the color page layer and a white background layer. We want to drag this color layer in between the two layers. Next, while selecting the color page layer, click the layer mask icon to add a mask. Then while selecting it, we invert it by pressing Ctrl-I on Windows or Command-I on Mac. Inverting the mask hides the entire layer, so we can later select the parts we want to reveal. On the mask, black areas are the hidden parts, while white areas are visible to us. With the mask selected, use the brush tool with the white paint selected. Adjust the brush size. and then we paint over the areas we want to reveal. If you feel like this is too slow, click the object selection tool and make sure to select the image thumbnail. And then roughly select the girl and it will guess the part you want to select. Under this selection, we go back to select the mask thumbnail. And we can use a bucket tool or bigger brush to make all this area white, which is to reveal the image. To get out of selection, click Ctrl or Command D. Then once we have this bigger area selected, we can use a smaller brush of white to continue to reveal other details. If you make a mistake, simply switch to a black brush to paint over it and hide the unwanted sections again. Remember, the entire revealing and hiding process needs to be done when the mask is selected on the layer. And by doing all these, you'll create a partially colored coloring page. So that's it for today. Let me know how you're planning to use this technique. The possibilities are endless. Check out these videos you might be interested in. Thanks for watching. I will see you soon. For more tips and tricks like this, sign up in the first link in the description below.